Oh, what should I draw? Thinking of great ideas takes up so much time. Designs from around the world. This book should give me some ideas. These designs are great. And some of them seem to be formed from the same tiny design being repeated over and over again. Hey, Dr. O, take a look at this.
You are right, JC. This design is made of the same pattern being repeated over and over again. You want to learn more about patterns, JC?
Yes, Dr. O. Let's learn the concept of patterns together.
A pattern is formed when a set of shapes, numbers, or designs are repeated over and over again. Patterns are found everywhere in our world. You can see patterns in the floor tiles of your room, in flowers, in architecture, and in objects that we use every day. Take a look at this t-shirt, JC. The triangles on it form a pattern. The pattern is formed by a triangle, followed by an upside-down triangle being repeated over and over again. Once you identify a pattern, you can take it forward yourself.
Completing patterns is quite easy.
Yes, JC. All you need to do is first decide the shapes or numbers that you will use and arrange them in a particular pattern. Let's take a look at some patterns and see if we can complete them ourselves. Let's look at this pattern now. You must have noticed that in this figure, a circle follows a square and a square follows a circle. This is the pattern rule of this figure. Patterns which show this type of continuity are known as continuing patterns. Let's complete this pattern. To complete this pattern, we will continue the series of a circle followed by a square. And a square follows a circle. Now, look carefully. Can you identify the pattern rule here?
Yes, Dr. O. A triangle is followed by an upside-down triangle and then a circle. These three shapes are repeated once more in the pattern.
Now, let's repeat these shapes and continue the pattern. Do you know, JC, that even numbers follow patterns? Let me show you an example. Can you identify the pattern rule here?
4, 40, 400, 4000, not really.
If you look carefully, you will see that the previous number, when multiplied by 10, gives the next number. 4 multiplied by 10 is equal to 40. 40 multiplied by 10 is equal to 400. 400 multiplied by 10 is equal to 4000. JC, can you guess what's the next number?
The next number is 4000 multiplied by 10. That is 40,000.
That's good. Now, let's try another pattern.
1, 3, 4, 7, 11, 18. Now, this looks tricky.
Here's how. We add the previous number to the current number to get the next number. So what's the next number after 18?
The next number is 11 plus 18 equals to 29.
Some patterns around us are known to be symmetrical. Do Do you remember what line symmetry is? If a figure or pattern can be folded into mirror halves, so that one half fits exactly on top of the other, then we say it has got line symmetry. This line that divides the figure into mirror halves is called the line of symmetry. Let's take this butterfly for example. The line of symmetry divides the figure of the butterfly into equal and identical halves. Let's complete this pattern along its line of symmetry. This pattern has four lines of symmetry. While completing this pattern, we must take into account not only its shape, but also its color. So, JC, did you enjoy working with patterns?
Yes, Dr. O. And now that you have taught me all about patterns, I think I'll keep observing them wherever I go.
That's great, JC.
Yes, thank you, Dr. O. Let's revise all that we have learnt about patterns. A pattern is formed when a set of shapes, numbers or designs are repeated over and over again. While completing continuing patterns, identify the pattern rule. While completing a pattern along its line of symmetry, draw the other half so that the halves fit together perfectly. When the shape pattern is folded in half,